Well, I began my work here at the Beckman Institute almost 10 years ago. And when I began that work, my specific area is medical imaging. And I came from biomedical engineering at McGill University in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. And I began to develop small types of contrast agents for medical imaging purposes. And I began to realize that they would be good agents to deliver compounds to improve health. So the early work that I did here at the Beckman Institute involved the creation of actually nanoparticles, some of which have actually been patented by the university. And subsequently, I developed other types of nanoparticles for the delivery of compounds and the treatment of health. Simultaneously, I did a lot of work imaging, particularly of the brain, here within the Institute because of our really advanced magnetic resonance imaging facilities. And I began to look at brain and neurofiber mapping. At the same time, then I was beginning to map corpus callosal fibers connecting one side of the brain with the other, and I realized that there was a real need to understand traumatic brain injury. When you take all this together, it really is a body of work that addresses health and attempts to monitor health, particularly brain health and the delivery of compounds to improve health. So I got into working with the combat helmet because of a call from the congressionally directed medical research program to try to identify traumatic brain injury in battlefield personnel. And I proposed to them that we develop a combat helmet. This is my combat helmet. And I proposed that we embed health monitoring technologies into the pad structure, along with also embedding into the helmet a computer chip that does all of the work. So at this point, I started to combine my work with nanosensing technologies and brain imaging to try to develop a real-time battle helmet that could identify perhaps the onset of traumatic injury. Not diagnose it, just identify when soldiers may be in trouble. Well, that's kind of the whole purpose of what we do here in the Institute, and that is to try to expand our knowledge to be able to identify advanced technologies that actually can help somebody. It would be a real thrill to be able to do that, and I'm currently talking with the government to try to advance this helmet one more step. And just as an addition, I really have a lot of colleagues within the university that work with me on this, including Robbie Iyer, who's our Vice Chancellor for Research, and a lot of other members of the Coordinated Science Lab. If one is able to take some of these advanced technologies and really make them either diagnose or help treat individuals with various types of disorders, especially for me, chronic diseases, then it's fun for me, and I enjoy the work, and hopefully it can be translated into something that will help people.